had the whole thing twisted up. Yeah. Do you guys understand that? And listen, to the carnal mind and to our society, we think that sounds horrible, what I just said, about not being worried about our own life and being filled with care for other people's lives over our own. But that's actually the most blessed feeling inside of a person. That's actually what gives birth to the most joy. That's actually the most blessed life you can experience. A life where your mind isn't filled with your own life, but a life where your mind is filled with preferring other people's lives over your own. Not by your willpower to do that. Mm-hmm. That would be a cursed life.
Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying? Do you see how subtle it is? You can behold the life of God and see that's beautiful, but if you think you got to now work that, that would be a cursed life. So you don't look at the life of God and see that it's beautiful and say, how can I do that? You look at the beautiful life of God and say it's a blessed life and say his life will manifest it in me. That's why I talk over and over about eternal life, because I'm hoping I'll say it enough ways and enough different ways that everybody's heart will be captivated by this word of life.
Yeah.
Even if they don't understand it all, they'll start thinking, maybe there's something to this eternal life. Even if their heart just starts inquiring with God. What is it with this eternal life, Lord? I mean, what the hell? I'm not sure I understand it. What about this immortality? What does this mean, right? Yeah. And even if your heart can just start inquiring into that, God will start bringing forth understanding in you, and he'll start ministering to your heart, mm-hmm. right? But it feels, listen, after it happens to you, it feels real nice. When you find yourself more concerned about other people than yourself, it feels nice. In fact, the whole world acknowledges that that's nice. We just have different ideas about how to bring it forth.
Yeah.
And then those that try to bring it forth through their own works, they end up bringing something else forth. Mm-hmm. Right? Thorns and thistles.
Yeah.
And then they end up setting up this thing where they judge other people that they don't think are doing the good that they're doing.
Right.
Something about the life of God, when you prefer other people, when it's born in you, and you prefer other people's lives over yourself, you're not judging the other people whether or not they're getting it right like you. That's one of the aspects of preferring someone else's life over your own.
Mm-hmm.
You're not busy examining their life to see whether or not they're getting it right or whether or not they have enough fruit or what. You're not thinking of them people in terms like that, right? You're not thinking of it like that. Does that make some sense?